I'm Virginia.
Hi, I'm Isabel. Today, we'll be going over the physics of paper airplanes. If you're interested in making some models to explore what we talk about, feel free to take a look at our previous video on how to make different paper airplanes.
Paper airplanes can look wildly different, from the classic dart design to the broad, wide wing. But why do they vary so much, and how does that impact their flight? It all has to do with the four forces that work on planes: lift, thrust, gravity, and drag.
Lift is what makes paper airplanes, or planes in general, fly. Lift is caused by a pressure difference on the plane's wing. When air travels over a wing, air on the top moves faster because its path has been narrowed, resulting in less pressure. Because the bottom air is still slow and high pressured, it is still pushing up on the plane with the same force. This causes the plane to go up, what we call lift.
Thrust is important because it causes lift. On a paper airplane, you control thrust based on how hard you throw the plane. When the plane is thrown harder, more force is introduced into the system, so the pressure difference is greater, increasing lift. Without thrust, lift is impossible. Think about when you drop a paper airplane. It doesn't fly then.
Gravity is the force that pulls things down on Earth. It is working to fight lift in order to bring the plane down, and in this context, it's also called weight, because it is the weight of the airplane that brings it down. That's why paper airplanes are able to fly, where an airplane the same size made out of metal would fall.
Drag is the last force, and it opposes thrust. It slows the plane down through friction with the air. When the plane rubs against the air as it flies, the air doesn't want to move, so the plane has to use energy to push through, the same way you use energy to push your chair in or to close the door. This slows it down.
You can see these forces at work with different models of airplanes. The traditional paper airplane, the dart, needs a lot of thrust because it doesn't have very big wings and needs more help getting lift.
The wide wing, on the other hand, has very big wings, so a forceful throw will just unbalance it. A light toss will allow it to glide best.
Try experimenting at home to see how different paper airplanes act differently. What will happen if you change the material or the wing size or the force you throw?
Thanks for watching, and feel free to let us know in the comments or via email how your experiment turns out. As always, you can reach us at frc5587@gmail.com if you have a question or if you just want to say hi.